In last and a few sessions, probably a couple of sessions, we started off with defining low pass and band pass signals. We started with properties of low pass signal as definition and as well as for band pass signal. And we started with representing band pass signal in terms of low pass and vice versa. And we started with taking band pass signal into consideration, and we derived a low pass equivalent of this band pass signal. In between, we derived, you know, a special transform called as Hilbert transform as well. Probably equations 4 and 7 represented low pass equivalent of band pass signal. So equation number 7 represents in time domain. Equation number 4 represented in frequency domain. It is just downshifted version of the band pass signal. Okay. So with that, we can also find out the other way around, where given low pass signal, how can we represent, how can we convert it into band pass signal? Okay, so it was just translating the low pass signal into higher frequency spectrum, and equation number 8 straight away gives you one realization in time domain, and which can also be taken, you know, with Fourier transform as represented in frequency domain. With this note, we have, you know, equipped with representation of low pass signal into band pass, or converting low pass into band pass and vice versa in both time domain and frequency domain. We are good to go with, you know, little more discussion about this low pass and band pass signals and their block diagram representation based on these expressions. Back to this expression, which, you know, I'd be picking as, you know, starting point for this session, XL of t. We have represented this conversion from or representing band pass signal in its low pass equivalent. So XL of t, that we have written it as x of t cos 2 pi f naught t plus x hat of t sine 2 pi f naught t, okay, plus j times x hat of t times cos 2 pi f naught t minus x of t times sine 2 pi f naught t. Okay. So this expression, and we obviously we know that this has got its real part and, you know, imaginary part. So I can, you know, in shorthand notation, I can represent this as, you know, xi of t plus j xq of t. Okay, I'll tell you what is this xi of t and xq of t. So xi of t can be thought of as an in-phase component. Okay, and obviously xq of t can be obtained from xi of t. So this, if this is xi of t, the imaginary part of xl of t can be obtained by just taking, you know, quadrature shift or 90 degree phase shift of xi of t. And hence this is known as simply quadrature component. Okay. Note that these two, xi of t and xq of t, are real valued low pass signals. Okay. So, but xl of t, is your, you know, complex quantity, because it, you know, has got only, as we have seen, that doesn't obey the Hermitian symmetry property. So where this xi of t, which is the, you know, in phase component, which is, you know, the first half or real part of xl of t, can be written as, or I can say this as real of xl of t, which is simply x of t times cos 2 pi f naught t plus x hat of t times sine 2 pi f naught t, because we'll be utilizing this in our block diagram representation of extracting in phase and quadrature component from the band pass signal. And xq of t is in fact the imaginary part of this, is equivalently x hat of t times cos 2 pi f naught t minus x of t times sine 2 pi f naught t. Let me call this as both equations as probably equation number 11. Okay. So we can do the other way around. So this is given x of t, which is a bandpass signal. We can represent its in phase and quadrature components. So given in phase and quadrature components, can we get back the bandpass signal? So this is just solving two simultaneous linear equations for other way around. So that we know from our basic theory that solving a pair of equations above, I can express x of t, in terms of xi and xq as xi of t times cos 2 pi f naught t minus xq of t sine 2 pi f naught t, and similarly x hat of t, which is your Hilbert transformed of transformation of x of t, is xq of t times cos 2 pi f naught t plus xi of t times sine 2 pi f naught t. Okay, let me keep this as equation number 12 for future reference. So the last expression that we have written, which is equation number 12, shows that any bandpass signal x of t can be expressed in terms of two low pass signals, one being xi of t and another being xq of t. Okay, so x of t, this means that any bandpass signal, just put a sentence there, any bandpass signal x of t can be expressed in terms of in phase and quadrature components, both being the low pass signals. Okay, so this is about in phase and quadrature components. So similarly, we can extract few more information out of this. Say I was talking about the pre-envelope or complex envelope, when we started off with representing a bandpass signal in its only, as x plus of t, if you can recollect from, probably previous to previous session, where that, has meaning. You'll get the meaning of complex envelope based on this discussion. Okay, so I can say envelope and phase of your bandpass signal x of t. So equation, previously we have written equation number 10, if I'm not wrong. Yeah, equation number 10 says that xl of t can be represented as xi of t plus jx of t. Let me pick that again. Yeah. So with this, we know that any complex quantity, like your any complex number, will have its magnitude and phase. So which magnitude represents the envelope of the signal. So I can say that this can be expressed in terms of polar coordinates. Okay, so in terms of polar coordinates, I can have its envelope or amplitude, being represented as rx of t, which is nothing but root of squares of its real and imaginary terms. All right, similarly, its phase can be represented as theta x of t, as we know that it is arctan, or tan inverse of imaginary part by real part. Okay, and hence we can represent the low pass signal xl of t as rx of t, which is the amplitude and the phase as e power j theta x of t. Okay, let's just call this representation in its envelope and phase as equation number 13. Okay, and now we can easily realize that this rx of t represents the envelope. Envelope is derived from its in phase and quadrature components, which are related to xl of t as its real and imaginary parts. And hence, this rx of t is a complex quantity. And hence, we call it as envelope or pre-envelope or complex envelope. So such definitions are derived out of this representation. We can as well, write in a very neat form.
So we haven't proved if rx of t is x plus of t, right? I mean, like, how do we know this is the complex envelope?
Yeah, x plus of t has come, all along from this definition only, right? Because x plus of t we have represented as x plus of t is represented as half of x of t plus j x half hat of t. Okay, and in turn we know that x of t, if it's a band pass signal, we can represent this in terms of its low pass equivalent xl of t, and again in turn this is a complex quantity. Hope you get the the interlink between the con there.
Okay.
So this is a, if you go back to the definition of x plus of t, we have represented in this fashion, which in turn has a relation with its low pass equivalent, and hence in its complex form. Okay, so with that note, we can also extend this definition of all these quantities by substituting this expression 13 in probably expression number I have to check back with the previous session. Substituting that last quantity which represented xl of t in its amplitude and phase domain, in the sense we have now represented xl of t in its polar form. So I'll substitute that polar form representation into this expression. So what would you get if you represent in this fashion? So put 13 in 8, where 8, just for the sake of easy, x of t we have represented it as real part of equation number 8 is given as real part of xl of t, translating your low pass signal into band pass signal. We represent it in time domain in this fashion, so we would get this as real part, where xl of t is rx of t into e power j theta x of t into e power j 2 pi f naught t, right? So if you try to expand this and take real part, we know what we would be getting. So this rx of t, and taking just the real part of it, e power j x e power j y, e power j times x plus y, and taking real part of it will give you only the cos argument. So this is simply 2 pi f naught t plus theta x of t. Okay. Yeah, so there are so many references in our equations here. As and when necessary, we'll come back to these expressions and utilize. So this x of t in time domain now can be expressed in a very neat form, where so this gives meaning of this expression. This writing expression probably may not be so clear. Okay. Yeah. Just try to expand this.
So will you be also explaining what the envelope actually means, or is
yeah,
that something
I'll,
that will not
yeah. Yeah, I'll explain what is this all. So based on this time diagram of our signal representation in time domain, you'd be able to appreciate this. If you carefully look at the equation number 14, which is representation of a bandpass signal whose amplitude is given as rx of t and whose frequency f naught of t f naught is varying with respect to its phase, which is also time domain representation. So if I take a band pass signal, we know that a band pass signal in time domain is a rapid variations in time, which, you know, f naught is a very high frequency, much greater than your zero. So which is, you know, probably, you know, in RF ranges of frequencies. So if I try to represent that kind of waveform, so probably I can represent this as, it's a cos function. It's a high, you know, frequency component. Just, you know, one kind of representation. Okay, pardon me for any, you know, irregularities and not drawing so neatly, but this will give you some idea. Okay, so if I have, you know, some, you know, random signal cos 2 pi f naught of t plus theta x of t, where it is varying with respect to time, then if I, you know, connect all the pieces here, this would represent my the envelope of signal x of t. Okay, some random waveform. Okay, so this dotted part will give you some representation of your envelope R x of t. Okay, and this envelope, what we mean is a complex envelope. Okay, so as you can see, the frequency variations within this envelope is rapid, but if you just try to extract this R x of t, it is, you know, some signal, but it has got, you know, slow variations in time domain. Okay, and hence we can say that, you know, R x of t is represented by in turn by x I and x q, which both are low pass, you know, signals. Okay, so and hence, you know, this would be the representation of your, you know, of your bandpass signal x of t. Okay, all right. So one important, you know, point that you should be noting at this
part. Excuse me, sir.
Yes, please. Yes, please.
Sir, so Rx of t shouldn't be the amplitude. It should be the change in amplitude of the signal, right?
It is just, you know, Yeah, please go ahead.
Yeah, so because how the amplitude is changing with respect to the waveform, Rx of t is just, you know, like how does like how an envelope works, it is just uncovering the signal, right? So it shouldn't be the amplitude to be specific, but the change in amplitude.
Well, it's not the change in amplitude. No, Rx of t, it is just, you know, at any point of time, you know, Kashish, at any point of, you know, a given time, you just have to take, you know, xi of t and xq of t, and, you know, square of those terms with square root will give you the instantaneous amplitude of the bandpass signal x of t. It is not that, you know, time rate of change of x of t. It is just the amplitude or its envelope at, you know, instant of t. It is just a number. It is not the variations.
Okay.
Yeah. I hope I was clear there. You know, just, you know, envelope Rx of t just represents within what variations of your bandpass signal is enclosed with. It is just, you know, wrapping of this bandpass signal by connecting their peaks would give you the envelope of that signal. Oh, yeah. Well, I was mentioning about, you know, one important quantity that all the signals xi of t, your xq of t, the in-phase and quadrature components, and hence with which we have got now the amplitude and the phase theta x of t are defined, okay, are defined at certain frequencies, at some central frequency f naught. Okay, if it's not in a symmetry, I can call just, you know, some, you know, frequency f naught. Hence, for any given band pass signal x of t, we will have its equivalent low pass signal defined at a certain frequency f naught. So for a specific f naught, we will have, you know, a specific representation of its low pass equivalent. So given another, you know, value of f naught, we'll have other you know, representation of its equivalent low pass signals. So this implies that I mean to say that is for a given bandpass signal x of t, okay, yeah, different values of f naught. In other words, different values of f naught would give different low pass signals. It's very, you know, obvious from the, you know, representation of the time domain. I can say from, you know, this picture itself. Say if this is one certain frequency, although I have not, although it seems that my diagram here represents a, you know, multiple frequency content in the signal, but it's not. It is drawn for a, you know, specific value of f naught. We can see that if I change the frequency, obviously the variations will change, and, you know, probably the envelope shape will also change. So if the envelope shape changes, that represents that, you know, that implies that my xi of t and xq of t are also different. And hence, for a specific value of f naught only, we define its low pass equivalent. And xi of t and xq of t are unique only at that given f naught. Yeah. Modulation, as we know, that it's a process of converting your low pass signals to, you know, a band pass. So this is the process where converting, up converting your low frequency signals into higher frequency signal in order to suit or in order to match the channel properties. So we have represented, you know, in two different forms, one in a complex form where we represented x of t as, you know, as real part of x l of t times e power j 2 pi f naught t. Okay, so this block diagram is direct realization of that quantity. So this double arrows indicate it's a complex operation. Okay, so this double arrows indicate it's a complex operation. Okay, yeah. So multiply xl of t with e power j 2 pi f naught t, and, you know, take real part of it, you would be getting the band pass signal, or the translated version of your low pass signal x of t. We tried to substitute e power j 2 pi f naught t in terms of cos 2 pi f naught t plus j 2 pi f naught t, and xl of t will also have its real and imaginary parts. Multiplying those two those quantities, we also got probably this, this was equation number 8, if I'm not wrong, and this was equation number 12. I'm just, you know, rewriting those expressions. You have written x of t as xi of t times cos 2 pi f naught t minus xq of t times sine 2 pi f naught t. Okay, so it's just, you know, implementation of that modulation scheme. Okay, the multiplication, you know, in your circuits, probably you can use simple, you know, MOS analog multiplier, or a simple MOS will give you the multiplication of two analog signals. So can be implemented, you know, in a circuit perspective. If it is, you know, modulation from low pass to band pass, the other part, which is, you know, demodulation, I've just, you know, taken this block diagrams directly in order to save, you know, some time. So we have extracted, I mean, we have written this block diagram based on equation number 7. If you can recollect, we have written this x l of t as x of t plus j hex hat of t times e power minus j 2 pi f naught t. So this is demodulation, where you convert your band pass at the receiver, band pass, you know, or you can say extracting low pass from band pass, or you can say simply band pass to low pass conversion. Okay, so this block diagram implements equation number 7, where x hat of t represents h, where h this indicates, okay, where this h indicates the Hilbert transform. Okay, and this expression is very evident what we have written, you know, just before, which is equation number 11, where xi of t is written as x of t times cos 2 pi f naught t plus x hat of t times sine 2 pi f naught t, and xq of t, which is quadrature version of it, which is written as x hat of t times cos 2 pi f naught t minus x of t. I've just, you know, rewriting those expressions which we have written earlier just for the sake of clarity. Okay. Yeah. So as part of our objective of discussion of low pass and band pass, we have done with the first part, interconversion of low pass and band pass, and representation of band pass in terms of its equivalent low pass and vice versa. And all we need to, you know, cover the last part of it, where the relation between low pass and band pass in terms of its energy and inner product of, you know, signals, you know, in its frequency domain, in other words. Okay. All right. So let's cover last, you know, few parts of discussion of low pass and band pass very quickly. Okay. We'll talk about their energy considerations. So we know that the energy of any signal can be represented as, so we know that, we'll talk about, you know, with the specific signal, which is a band pass signal. All along the, our discussion, we have used x of t as a band pass signal, is given as energy taking its magnitude squared, okay, which in its frequency, you know, domain representation, using your probably Parseval's theorem or Rayleigh theorem, where we have, we can represent, yeah, probably using your Rayleigh's theorem, a Fourier transform property. Okay, now we'll try to relate the energy of a band pass signal with respect to energy of a low pass signal. How are these signals in their energy perspective are equivalent? Okay, so with this definition of energy of any given signal, we know that x of f, you know, is a frequency domain representation of a band pass signal, which we have earlier represented as, which has got positive spectrum and negative spectrum. Okay, we know that we represented x of f in this manner. So this implies that energy of a signal, by substituting x of f with this, we can write this as x plus of f plus x minus of f whole square df. Expanding this, you know, a plus b whole square term, I will have a term which x plus of f whole square df b square, which is x minus of f square df, plus obviously twice of, you know, these two, or in other words, we, you know, take a product of x plus of f into complex conjugate of x minus of f plus x minus of f into complex conjugate of x plus of f. Nevertheless, if you take the product of, you know, these two quantities, we know that x plus of f, if f represents the frequency spectrum for all positive frequencies, x minus of f represents all the spectrum in its negative frequency domain. So the product of those two will not have any common term. Okay, so that the product of these two will be zero. Okay, noting that, so that term vanishes. X plus of f times x minus of, will not have any, you know, common term, which will give you the value zero. Okay, so I can also, using the, you know, Hermitian symmetry property, also we know that the magnitude of x minus of f is given as x plus conjugate of minus f. Okay, so this implies that I can write this energy of a bandpass signal, where magnitude of this is equivalent to this, minus f doesn't harm anything because it will just change the limits from infinity to minus infinity. If I take the entire frequency range, the magnitude, you know, will not, you know, harm anything. So it will be simply twice of minus infinity to infinity x plus of f whole square df. Okay, so we know that energy of any signal is represented in this fashion, and the right hand side I can represent in this as its energy of the signal x plus of t. Okay, so this implies that energy of a band pass signal x of t is twice of energy of x plus okay, where x plus of t again can be represented in its low pass equivalent. Okay, so this proves one of the part of one theorem. In other words, I can represent directly with its low pass equivalent. It is just representation in terms of x plus of t. I can continue this to make it crisp representation with respect to its low pass equivalent. So using the fact that xl of f, we have utilized this x plus f naught, not taking anything from the air. I think this was the one which we did it in the very beginning of the definition, where x plus of f, let me check. Yeah, I think it was in the earlier session or not. Yeah, this was the one. So I'm utilizing this representation where xl of f we have represented as a downshifted version of your x plus of f, and of course we multiplied with the multiplication factor 2, which eventually got cancelled out. So utilizing this equation number 4, we can I've just read that expression here. So this implies that x plus of f plus f naught is half of xl of f, and we know that x plus f naught magnitude will not change. It is just the shifting of the spectrum of these signals. This implies x plus of f, I can write this as half of xl of f. Okay, of course the magnitude of that. So this implies the left hand side represent the energy of the signal. All right, just give me a second. Yeah, so this implies energy of the signal that we know is twice of minus infinity to infinity x of f the whole square df, which is equivalent to, now x plus of f is half of xl of f, so substituting that term, minus infinity, which is magnitude of xl of f by 2 the whole square df. By rearranging the term, we will get this as half of minus infinity to infinity magnitude of xl of f whole square df. So this implies that the energy of the bandpass signal ex is simply the half of, the right hand side represents the energy of xl of t, which is short form representation of exl. So these relations are pretty much evident that the energies with respect to the energy, the low pass equivalent signal, the half energy of its low pass equivalent signal will have then equivalent to the energy of its band pass signal. It's simple mathematical relation that we can conclude with. Okay, all right, so we'll also cover quick, yes please,
magnitude of x plus f plus x of f plus f naught is equal to x plus of f. Is that because Correct. We're just frequency shifting it and that doesn't change the magnitude That's spectrum?
Not. That doesn't change anything with respect to magnitude. It's just shifting on its, on the right.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah. All right. So I was just, a little quicker there where it is simple relation in a mathematical relation between quantities. So we'll also have this quantities will be revisited again after we discuss quadrature sampling or a bandpass sampling. But please have the energy relations and inner product of two signals by their definitions, which will be helpful in understanding signal constellation, probably in the second half of unit one. Okay. So what do you mean by inner product? So inner product of two signals is represented as x of t.
It's the dot product, basically.
Yeah, it's a dot product. It's a dot product in your vector domain. So in signal domain, if you have x of t and y of t as two signals, we represent it as integral minus infinity to infinity x of t times y conjugate of t dt. Okay, so if it's a real signal, if y of t is a real signal, obviously it will be just a product of x of t and y of t, and taking taking the area under the curve of product of x of t into y of t. So in strict sense, it is multiplication of x of t times a complex conjugate of the other signal y of t. In equivalent to in frequency domain, we also have the Fourier transform property that in its frequency domain, it is represented as x of f times y star of f df by your Parseval's theorem. Okay, so that, I'm sorry. Yeah, so that the energy of a signal, now you can define energy of the signal x of t. Okay, what is the energy of signal? We have defined energy of the signal is simply the magnitude of x of t the whole square, which is equivalent to replacing y of t with x of t itself. Okay, so in general, the energy or the inner product of two signals is represented as x of t times complex conjugate of y of t. If it so happens that if I replace y of t with x of t itself, with the same signal itself,
inner product of x comma x.
Exactly. So it's inner product of x of t and x of t, right? So which gives the energy of the signal. Okay. I'll repeat these relations again will be helpful in second half of this unit itself. So I can represent Ex as inner product of the signal x of t and x of t itself. Okay. So with this definition, we can try to relate the inner product of two bandpass signals and what would be the relation with respect to the inner product of its low pass equivalent or their low pass equivalents. Okay, so by utilizing the similar expression, this can be taken as an exercise. I think it's one of the exercise problem of your prokis as well. Okay, so I'll just quickly do that in probably in couple of minutes of time. We are at 9:53. Okay, hopefully we'll not be consuming much time. We have x of f as half of, we are represented as f minus f naught plus xl star, the last expression, equation number 14, which I try to recorrect today in our session. Okay, so xl star minus f naught. Similarly, we have another bandpass signal y of f, which can be similarly represented as f minus f naught plus yl star minus f naught. Okay, so using the definition of inner product y of t, okay, which is x of t y conjugate of t dt equivalently minus infinity to infinity x of f y star of f. Okay, we have got now x of f and y conjugate of f. Then just utilizing these two expressions above, I can write this as half of minus infinity to infinity product of these two quantities. Okay, so if I take, I'll just skip one step here, say this represents the product of x of f times complex conjugate of y of f. So product of these two terms will give you half into half, which is 1/4. Two terms in each. So we would be hoping to get four terms out of these. But carefully, if you observe, the product of xl of f minus f naught into yl f minus f naught and xl of f minus f naught into yl star of f minus f naught, out of these two, only one will exist, only from the fact that xl of f minus f naught, it's a right shifted version of your xl of f. Yl of minus f naught, it's on the negative frequency scale. Okay, so again, there will not be any common terms if you take product of these two quantities. Okay, so only the non-zero quantities, if I try to extract, only these products will be retained. You can check yourself, which is xl of f minus f naught times yl star of f minus f naught. Okay, the other product will be zero because there will be no common terms, df plus 1 by 4 minus f naught minus infinity, infinity similar to the previous argument. I will have only the non-zero quantity of this product into, oh, sorry, this should be minus f minus f naught, yeah, yl times minus f naught df. Just changing the arguments, okay, with, so I can rewrite this, you know, in a simpler form. So this is nothing but,
so won't it be xl f minus f naught into yl f minus f naught, not star?
No, that product will not be there, right? Because we are taking the product of x,
oh, you're
of
taking
f
y star of f,
y star conjugate of f. Yeah, that will not be there. Hmm. Yeah, and just taking a dummy variable, replacing f minus f naught with u and yl star of u, say, if it replace f minus f naught with u, df will be simply du because f naught being a constant. So plus 1 by 4 minus infinity to infinity xl complex conjugate of, say, some v times yl times v dv. So this is my inner product, what I am writing here. Okay, so this you can realize, you know, can be simplified as simply minus real half of real part of x l of f times, well, this is a simple, you know, relation. I'll just give you as an exercise, you can work it, you know, yourself and understand that the 1/4 of these products of real and complex conjugates will give you just half of real part of, you know, one of the quantities in something like this, which I want to conclude that the xl of f into yl star of f is nothing but half of real of, you know, real part of, you can represent this product of xl of f into yl star of f as what? It is simply the inner product of xl of t and l of t. Okay? This is how your inner product of your band pass signal is related with inner product of its low pass equivalent.